how do you reconcile being feminist but also demanding men adhere to their more traditional gender roles, such as paying for first dates, chivalry, et cetera, et cetera? How do you reconcile that?
Because feminism is about social spheres to me. So even if women were to occupy 50% of Congress, 50% of leadership roles, were to, you know, 50% CEOs of Fortune 500 companies, that doesn't, you know, affect the fact that if you and I were dating and we were hooking up, I'm the one who has to take birth control so that you can nut in me. If we were to have a kid, I'm the one who has to bear the child.
Are you on birth control?
No, I'm not fucking. But, or if, you know, when we have a child, I'm the one who's going to have my pussy torn open to bear your child. We, you know, I'm the one who has to breastfeed. So at the end of the day,
sure,
you can only go 50-50 so far. And this idea of going 50-50 in terms of bills is actually just more of a burden on the woman, because you can never go 50-50 in terms of actual reproductive.
But that
goals.
Assumes that the first person you ever date, that ends up becoming your husband and the person you have children with. So
not necessarily, even you if you're even if you're children. Just hooking up. I mean, birth control increases your chance of breast cancer by 20%.
Dating,
it fucks up your hormones.
So,
I'm just like altering my body.
But so if
you.
I'm dating a woman who's not on birth control and she doesn't want to have children, under those circumstances, would you be okay with the woman, like a 50-50 dynamic, or even then you'd object to it?
It's not that I would object. I would just say, generally, given the dynamics of dating and the idea that usually people are having sex and that women are taking birth control so that the man can have increased sexual pleasure.
A lot of women
are
not on birth control.
Okay, well, just given the idea of like a goal of a relationship, which is typically that you're dating to have kids, or you're dating to marry to then have kids. So I'm seeing it more in like a macro sense. I think the idea of 50-50 is ridiculous.
Well, she just went on 100.
If you're just doing hookup culture and whatever she's doing, then I don't think, I think 50-50 seems more fair, yeah.
What about you? I mean, you just went on 100 first dates in the past two months. Do you want a guy to pay for the first date?
I don't want them, but I think this is a great indication of where they are in life. So if somebody doesn't...
Well, earlier in the conversation, mm-hmm. you said you want a guy who matches you.
Exactly.
Or exceeds you.
So if they feel like they cannot, for whatever, I'm just assuming that it's their materialistic situation that doesn't allow them to pay for the date, it probably not somebody I should be seeing, because it's going to cause tension later on.
Okay.
But that's completely optional. Like, there, if they want to split, I'll split it.
Would there be a second date? You might split
it. Depends
split
on
it.
How much I like them, because it's not all
so
about
it would
the
be,
money.
So it would be a negative if a guy did wanted to split the bill.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Do you want to take it over?
Well, what about this commune? Okay, I'm not. We don't have to get back into that. But
that's where my like traditional values come. I don't think it's like against anybody. Like, it's 50-50, but like for my goals of like, I want a big family, like, and that's again, where, what are you dating for? You need to like find out your purpose. So if like I was dating right now to like have like a family, like, of course I'm not going to date like the guy who works at Subway, because he probably doesn't make enough money
here
to provide
for
four kids.
Let me ask you two a question. So you said societally you want equality, but when it comes to romantic relationships, you want tradition. Would you...
It's not that I want tradition. I think that the biological imperative of men and women is going to be there, even if women are CEOs and are taking on a more masculine role.
Yes, I agree.
In larger
I agree
society.
With that. I agree with that.
Yeah.
Would you take your husband's last name?
If it was a nice last name, yeah.
Yeah.
What about you? Would you take your husband's last name?
Oh yeah.
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 I'm not,
I mean, if I was super like Kim K famous, then I'd probably do a hyphenated like Kardashian West
really.
Situation.
But so you're saying, You demand tradition romantically, but romantic tradition would dictate that in a marriage you would take your husband's last name and your children would also have your husband's last name, regardless of how egregiously bad his last name was or wasn't.
Yeah, I mean, the kids can take his
name
or both
names. No, but you would take it too. That's tradition. Romantic. That's tradition.
Well,
romantically.
I said some traditional values. I didn't say necessarily relationships have to be entirely traditional. I said in terms of paying the bills, I have more traditional
values.
Well,
when the
values.
Kid is born, what name does he get? Does the kid get?
I guess it's up to the couple at hand if they want to hyphenate
no,
it.
Your,
if they
no, but
pick
your,
one.
In your traditional worldview, when it comes to dating, anyways.
Yeah.
Your feminist traditional worldview.
For me personally, I want to keep my name for my own branding. For like the average couple, I think you could hyphenate
it.
I think
if you had
either.
A kid,
that's not traditional though.
Yeah. So, and if you had a kid,
I said some traditional values. My point was,
so you only want
bills.
The traditional values that benefit you.
It's not about benefiting. It's about evening out the fact that
evening
my reproductive role is not 50-50. So why would we go 50-50 on bills?
Well, what about the fact that
we can't go 50-50 on that caregiving aspect?
But if you are in the caregiving aspect and you're staying at home, you're taking care of the kid, your obligation to that is only 18 years. So if he's working, right, he's working to support you the entire time. Mm-hmm. After that obligation is done, he's still working and you're not working. So in some ways, you get a shortcut to retirement. Example.
Wow. Yo, AB Check, thank you so much, man, for the gift of 50 memberships. An example?
Yeah, example. Me and my wife, okay? The youngest one that I have now left at home 12 years old, okay? That's not going to, or 11, sorry, 11 years old. It's not that long, okay? That's only, what, a few short years before she may launch out of the pad. Well, now my wife, she's pretty young. She's still pretty young, and she'll still be fairly young even when that happens. But I'll still be taking care of and paying all the bills. She won't have to do any of that, right? So yes, she took care of her obligation on the front end, but on the back end, the man's still working the entire time. So I don't see where this idea of fairness comes from you when you say, well, it's because I have to give birth and then stay at home. It's like, well,
thank you, Honda.
That's the easier job, one. And then two, you're paid for even after the child's no longer needs 24-hour assistance. And remember, the time frame when that happens, it's only the first 2-3 years when they really need round-the-clock assistance.
Yeah, mm-hmm. I'm not correlating it to round-the-clock assistance. And also, yeah, most couples have more than one child. And yeah, so it's not just the first 18 years. It could be up to 30 years in theory.
Yeah, even if it could, if it's 30 years.
Yeah, obviously,
right?
They could tailor it to their actual familial duties and their plans.
Right, but really, even when you look at the cycle, let's say you had 5-6 kids, something like that. Most people won't. They'll have 2 or 3, right? But let's just assume it for the sake of assuming it. They usually spaced out by 2 or 3 years, okay? So they don't need round-the-clock assistance after the first couple of years. They don't need that anymore. And then the older they get, when they get to 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, basically every single year that goes, the less that you really have to focus on taking care of them, other than like basic meals, things like this, they can basically take care of themselves. They can
brush their own teeth, comb
their own hair, everything.
Most mothers don't just...
It's not like they're 18
dead,
and they just fly just, away.
Well, I'm not saying that they are, but even then, when they're not flying away and they're 18, it's the man who's covering their bills then too.
So then if... question for you, Farah.
I just had a different upbringing, so it's like I'm
man
that
covering
outlier
their bills. But even
like,
if the kid stays, now the man's still taking care of that, and the mom doesn't have to take care of it at all. Not at all. Doesn't have to work, doesn't have to do anything, and the caregiving portion of it, that's gone. And the man's still working to take care of him, even if the kid doesn't
But
leave.
Is the wife not taking care of you anymore either? Like
well,
you know, cooking,
but,
cleaning,
but
and
if
stuff
you're
like
talking
that.
About what's equal, right, isn't the wife supposed to be doing that?
No, I am.
Right, so if
agreeing,
she's supposed
I'm
to
asking.
Be doing that as already as a baseline, you can't throw that in and say, well, it makes it more equal. That's just her job.
No, I didn't say it made it more equal. I was just asking if in your situation you're still expecting after all these things.
Oh, yeah,
happen,
no, I expect breakfast made. I expect lunch made.
And
I expect
you don't
dinner
think
made. I expect all of that. Yeah,
that's not a emotion. That's not a task. Like,
no, it's a task, but it seems like
you deserve to be compensated.
It doesn't seem very difficult compared to $200.
But have you tried
I'm
it?
I'm just catching up. Major Air Elf for modest Simpica. That 304 looks like our slurred Jasmine on crack. That's Simp Shiat. She won't bang you. Also, can the panel pronounce Miss Cognostic? Hashtag I want smoke.
What word are they? Misogynistic?
Yeah, we had a girl in the previous show totally butcher the pronunciation of that word. Thank you, LP. Appreciate it, man.
So anyway, when you just kind of like dive back in maybe to wrap this up or whatever, but yeah, when you're talking about her tasks and duties, no, I don't think her tasks and duties are draining. I think that she was able, in fact, to have so much additional time based on my labor that she was able to write a best-selling book, which is a best-selling book right now that you can buy. And you know who gets all of the royalties of that book? Me. Every bit of it.
Oh.
Every bit. She doesn't. And if she gets any of it, it's due to my largest. Why? Because I took care of her for the entirety of her life and took good care of my children for the entirety of their life.
And do you have
we'll
a plan for them
so.
After you die?
Of course. assuming I'm the one who goes first, right? But you don't know how that'll go. But we're still looking at, we're still pretty young, right? Ultimately.
I just don't, like, when it comes to the whole tradition thing, I just don't understand, because, like, an 18-year-old woman, she's, is she immediately going to have children? What if that relationship doesn't pan out? Yeah. So that's all the value is front loaded on the man, because not every relationship is going to culminate in having children.
Yeah.
So
it's aligned with the way I date. So for instance, I'm not currently dating. I'm not on dating apps. Next time I date, I'm dating to marry. So that's more.
But you're an outlier, I guess, in that regard.
Sure, yeah, that's why I also mentioned the fact that I have more traditional values, perhaps, with dating goals.
But
like,
why,
I'm not dating for experience.
But you
I'm
have traditional values, but you claim to have traditional values, but you wouldn't take your husband's last name, which is a traditional value. You do OnlyFans, which is not traditional. Because my view is part of traditionality is modesty.
Sure, I don't think I need to subscribe to the entire, you know, package deal of traditionalism,
sure.
But that doesn't mean I'm cherry picking it.
It's
what I think is most fulfilling and what I think is most conducive to success. So for me, I value the idea of getting married. That's why I'm waiting until marriage. I value dating to get married. So I'm saying I don't see.
Wait, you're waiting until marriage for what?
To fuck.
To have sex?
Yeah.
You're waiting until marriage?
Yeah.
Why should that blow your mind? Because that's a traditional value.
No, that's fine. But I think she said something differently on a previous show. I think,
yeah, that's like the most. If Farah was saving gold bars, it'd be less valuable than that in this day and age. So no, nothing but props from me.
Wait, but you've previously answered that question differently. I guess my whole big thing is, you got women who want equality so societally.
Wait, but she's answered that question differently before?
Modest Hikima donated $200. Girl 2, look at your health, lol. Yikes, girl 3, you need to remember you have ears. Sorry for assuming, but your kids will be better off with a man in the home mirror. HMU Andrew, Ty.
Word?
I do agree
do
that
it
has
down,
to be
please?
A father Hello? Figure, but it does not have to be a biological father.
Wouldn't it be better, though, if it was?
It would be if the overall relationship was healthy and it did not affect psychological state of the parents, because okay. that would be reflected right. on the child.
Going to you, so the guy should pay for the first bill. What about, would you take, I think I already asked you, excuse me if I did.
Would
you
take, on a second date with
No. Would you take your husband's last name?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, all right. I guess one of my issues with this whole, like, your position is that you claim to believe in tradition, but it's rather traditional to take your husband's last name.
And I told you that's why it's not cherry picking. I'm saying I'm like looking at each traditional value and saying what do I consider the most
but
conducive
I think,
to a healthy
I
relationship. I don't know why taking his last name is going to lead to a healthy relationship. I think waiting to have sex to get married is going to lead to a healthy relationship.
But I don't think the husband paying for first dates when you first meet him is going to lead to a healthier relationship necessarily either.
Right, but her argument for that is, but on the front end, the woman bears more of a brunt, but that's not true. So that's my problem. It's like, that's not true. What you stated of the reason that I believe that men should be paying for more for me, mm-hmm. and it shouldn't be 50-50, is because on the front end, I think we have a bigger, or, you know, like a larger cross to bear than they do. But that's not true. It's not correct.
Not larger cross. I wasn't downplaying what men have to do. I was more so saying that, like, I think this idea of going 50-50 in bills isn't actually a true 50-50, because my point is we can never really go truly 50-50 in terms of child rearing and child bearing.
Yeah, but what I'm saying is that it should be 60-40 with the woman on the 60 side, right? So if your value was fairness anyway, that's what I'm saying. If your value is fairness and your argument is this isn't fair, right, I would make the same argument back, but just say, well, if that's the case, then you as the woman should probably be paying 60% and the man 40% and having the kids.
Here, I got
if it was about fairness.
It wasn't necessarily about fairness. I was more so talking about biological imperative. And I was saying it doesn't matter how much feminism we sustain in society. You can't out-feminist the fact that I have a pussy and you have a dick. And when we have a kid, I'm the one who's going to be facing that brunt. I'm the one who's going to have my body fucked up. I'm the one who's going to have suicidal ideation because I may be having postpartum depression. I'm just saying, like, 50-50, in my opinion, is a fraud.
Also, like,
well,
women...
Well, wait a second. But I kind of already responded to that, right? And said, no, that's not really true. You have less of a burden to bear over time from the beginning.
If I take 25 years out of the workforce to raise six of your kids, I have less of a burden.
Yeah. How do you not?
So I should be going.
How do you
50,
not
50?
Have less of a burden?
Wait, I'm confused. So I should be paying 50.
That's manual labor.
What if that's manual labor.
What if your job is just sitting on
that? That's manual labor. I didn't think that was I think that any job you can do in your pajamas can't be that hard.
No, my point was you were saying she just has to care for the kid for 18 years, and then after that, now she has a free
just
retirement.
Just pop in the DVD.
Yeah.
Popping the DVD for the kids.
Truly, if you came home and your wife was in her pajamas every day, mm-hmm. would that not like turn you off or make you feel a certain type of way?
I don't think here's what most men want as the outcome for their children, who for the most part, by the way, are sent off to public school and she's not watching them do nothing. Okay, they're sent off for 8 hours a day to an institution very far away from her, and that's most kids who are raised by women in current society. That's one. Two, even if she stays at home and she raises them, and on top of raising them, homeschools them, right? And she does that in her pajamas, then that's still the least lazy thing she could be doing in comparison to sending them off to public school. So yeah, I think when you're talking about the labor added and what they have to do to raise kids, they mostly outsource that anyway.
Why is there such this like
outsourcing takes time too?
Oh yeah, they have to wave at the school bus. It's a rough gig. They have to get their ass up at 6 a.m. to get them on a school bus.
Well, do you ever think about how much it would cost you to pay a nanny, to pay a house cleaner, to pay a private chef, to pay like all these individual jobs?
Let's reverse it. Well, let's just reverse it then. Okay, but what about how much it would cost for you to be able to stay at home all day and do absolutely nothing for the most part, right? And have cable television, have trash paid for, have your electric paid for, have all of your utilities, have vacations given to you, have all of that. That also has a high cost, a significant cost associated with it. So as you're bitching about, well, wait a second, my maid service should be compensated. It's like, well, your living expenses are already compensated. You have to do nothing for it.
Well, it's not nothing. And I don't think there's anything wrong with
agreeing
that we both
have to. It's get on the school bus and go back to bed. That's
in a marriage.
I wish.
I would hate for my husband to just literally look at me and think if I'm a stay-at-home mom that I just don't do shit all day. If you go work and you have to like shovel bricks and pick up bricks and break your back, you're probably doing more laborious tasks than me. But as your partner, it would be so disrespectful to think that.
To tell the truth? To tell the truth that
I don't know,
that,
to me,
Tiana,
that's
to tell
what
the truth
saying,
that
it sounds like your wife might be lazy.
Let's assume for a second I'm a bricklayer and I go out and I do this hard, awful, horrible job. And I started with no skills when I was doing it. It took me 6 years in order to just figure out how to start laying the brick. Okay, because that's what it takes as a mason. And then after that, I'm wrecking my body every single day, working 12 hours a day, lifting some of the heaviest stuff you can imagine for 12 hours straight. And I come home and you're like, well, it's pretty disrespectful to me. It's pretty disrespectful to me that you think I don't bust my ass the same way you do.
I'm just saying it's as a partner, if it's a true partnership, if the way you view it, I think it seems like it's a little bit more of a business to you. So, but if you're in more of a partnership, I think it would be really disrespectful if your husband came home and looked at you building a whole home for him, taking care of his kids, pushing
no,
his
he
kids
built
out
the whole home for
and
you.
Set. First of all, we're talking about modern times.
I'm talking in modern time.
Dudes really used to build houses. None of us know how to build a house.
I know how to build a house.
Created a house.
Andrew can build a house.
I can build a house.
Heard it from Andrew here.
That's fire. And more men need to learn how to build
a
house.
I don't know if I could build a. There's some
things. So
there might be some things in a house I couldn't build.
Do you have kids yet?
Are you more of a cabin guy? Is it more of a cabin?
Yeah.
But most people can't build a house. Okay. Most people go buy a house. But I'm just. Now I feel like you're pick partying. You know what I mean by build a home.
Okay. I'll try to be as charitable as I can be about this. Okay. Listen.
But I'm just saying, as if I pushed out three kids for you and you come home and you look at me raising your kids and you think I barely have done anything,
yeah,
that's
but
crazy.
What if I come home and I go, look, it took you 2 hours to pick up the house and keep it maintained. Okay. The washer and dryer is going, but you're not manually washing the clothes anymore. I mean, you literally throw them in a machine. And then you go and you put the kids on a school bus and the kids leave in a school bus.
But
what the hell else are you doing all day?
They have machines that do like manual labor people used to have.
I don't know. I used to be
there's
a
no
nanny.
Machines building houses,
and even
really.
As a nanny, people
but like,
keep up their houses.
I mean, there's have been technological advances.
Let's move on to something else.